Hello guys,
this is the second game I am playing. I was not at all very satisfied with the game I played. So let us see how I'll go with this game. I want to see a better player and I want to beat a better player. Then the mistake I have been doing is that I am playing very reactively. Like, that word reactively means that after the opponent plays, I am not thinking, I am just reacting to that, what I want to develop is, I want to see, okay, let's play this move, what are the effects, what threats do I perceive. This is becoming a major challenge for me. And I'm making blunders, which is resulting me in losing the games. Okay, I have a system blunder. Let's go with it. D5. Knight f3. Bishop f4. All standard going on till now. Okay, and now commit to the landline system by with e3. Okay, I don't have any worries. I will just continue my development. Move to d. Maybe two. Okay, I have. C3. Now I'm going to complete it. Now I'm happy. Because I have a pin. What is this H6 move taking? The 6 move is giving him protection. Now what I want to do is, I want to go and attack. With this move I am attacking the d7 pawn. He can respond with the bishop too. Okay. See, let us go for this. First one. The knight is threatening the knight on d2. After capturing knight on d2, I can capture it. Actually, this is not a threat in my opinion, because if you capture knight with d2, I can go with knight. If you capture first with bishop, then I will go bishop to f3, then I will capture with the d2 knight on bishop f3. Or if he captures knight to bishop, I will move f3 also. This is another problem for me. The next plan for me is bring the bishop to b5. Bring the bishop to b5 and pin the queen. Let me see what he what actions does he have. Actually I did not see. If he tries to defend the knight with the queen, रुके सही ओके Either he has to forward the calculating rights. But in understandable. So now what do you plan? Now he will be playing for 3-8. Next time will be 3-8. What is my escape route? My escape route should be Queen A6, then Queen A4, and then back. This should be my route. But I have a specific name to destroy his casting rights. That's a good thing for me. Now I want to cancel on the king's side itself because he has an open thing on the d5. So I want to cancel on the king's side itself and play smoothly. It is still okay, we will not take with the see what it is doing is that we know knight on b. He is threatening b pawn, but that is acceptable. He is threatening b pawn, that is going to cross the position. What I want to do is in my next move to rook b6 and threaten both knights. I have only queen a4, but if he plays pawn c6, I have the move bishop captures and then after that captures knight. That was good, but before all those things I need some captures because I need my king to be safe, so I need a few captures. Okay. So what I will do is, see if you start with bishop captures, then knight captures will, then knight captures will do what? Will attack my bishop twice. That is a problem for me because I am not in a position to defend. My bishop twice, take out the value of damage, so that is another option for me. So first let me capture the bishop, so first let me capture the knight. If I capture the knight, then knight on e4, then we can take the pawn and then we can attack. I can go there and defend this. But what if I capture knight? If knight e4, if I capture a knight e4, then he goes with this. Then my structure is ruined, right? That is exactly what I did not want. But let me see. Take the bishop or not. That's a relief. That's a relief. what I am doing is I am threatening a fork. What I am doing is I am threatening the fork. Okay, so here is capture. I am also capturing. Now I think these are favorable transactions for me. Now you can play knight to be rook to b6 and then win this type back. Okay. I thought one move could damage me. That is the queen to d5, but pawn is defending the bishop, so no problems. Okay. Now knight comes. So first I have to understand my weakness. This d3 square is weakness for me. But I am moving to the bishop can go. Also the bishop cannot fight there. That's okay. What this knight will do is that it will defend on this pawn. So if at all I capture, so if at all I captures the b pawn, this rook can stand here. Okay, my bishop is on e, so that's not a good one. If I get to b3, queen b3 check. What is it? I don't think so, it is going to be this king simply slides in and I'm wasting my time. But I have an idea. If I can go to queen to c6, what else would be 6-2? I'm not able to get clear, I don't know what to do. I can go to queen to c6, I can go to queen to c6, but rook b6, and what check, I can go to queen c5 check. And if there are going to check, queen c5 check, what. What I am trying to do here is I am trying to save the pawn on b6, b2. I am trying to save the pawn on queen on b2. That is how I make problems. What I am trying to do is study. Chill out, I am not going to check. I don't need to get to. What I think we should do is I think we should focus on so what to consider player for. A4, A6. I hope that's a weakness on B square as well. And of course I want to try this out. I'm not conclusive, but I have a feeling that I can play with it and survive. Let me see if I have time to do it. So my idea is to have an attack on the C7.1 as well. What happens if I attack the knight? Where can the knight go? What happens if I attack the knight? Where can the knight go? Let's suppose I press E4. Okay, let's have to press E4. Knight on B4 is covered. The square on B4 is covered with the queen. The square on B6 is covered with the queen. So we have to go back. And what happens if he has to go back and take it. And I take with the bishop, the pawn on C7. Then his queen and rook are attacked. Afterwards, what can he do? We can take this one. I take the rook, I take the queen. Now I think this is the plan. I think this is a good move. I feel that he has two options. I feel like he has two options. He can go A6. He can go A6. If he goes A6, I'll capture the knight. Okay. attacking the ship as well. I didn't see this. I was attacking the ship as well. So knight e7 was also ruled out. Okay. And what are his options? The queen cannot go on the white diagonal. The queen cannot go on the black diagonal as well. Let's see the instructions. The queen can come to c8 square, but I'll be just taking away the rook. Because I am winning the exchange. If he takes my queen, I take his queen. That is fine with me. Overall, I think this is a good exchange for me. Or otherwise, I would have simply gone for a knight and captured the bishop. That is also a good exchange for me. I had two choices to make, but I didn't value. I had two choices, two beautiful choices, but I chose this. Okay. I somewhat prepared. See, what I want to do is either win or lose, I do not care. But I want to calculate like this. This is the only way to improve in chess. And I don't want to improve in chess. So what are his possibilities? So now his time is also getting closer to me. This is also a positive for me. Okay, he takes the bishop. That's an interesting one. I have not considered this one. So I'll take the pawn. Now I want to lose my bishop. Okay, if you want, then I can go there as well. You can kill him. So I want to come back here. There are a lot of problems, so I'll go with the second idea that I got there. I'll capture the knight and then I'll threaten the bishop. If that is enough, but he has to do one thing to okay. The knight is sitting on the outpost because I cannot keep the knight. How can I protect this pawn? How can I protect the pawn? Okay. I don't have any idea. This e4 pawn is pretty awesome. handle this gate from the thing and bring the root there. You cannot bring the root anything like that, so the root and then you can come up again. So what is happening? So this is the room. But what the instrument is? I will capture it. This should be here. Yeah, it's clear in my idea. Also, we have seen that the queen cannot come in the immediate passage, so I have time to castle. So what is your plan, brother? And go on time with my students in seconds. But yeah, it's a long way. So I need to take the bishop. So does he have any way to save the bishop? Wait. This is what happens if... Fuck me. I'm afraid of this one. Losing two rooks, one blunder change the game. Fuck. How did I miss this idea? Night guys, sir. See, can I give a check? So let me think. This is the plunder which is losing it now. Okay, I have not lost the game. Can I use? So the queen cannot come to F and give a check. Okay, that is established. See what happens if. If I capture the bishop, what I'm doing is I'm threatening to capture its pawn. So, and then eventually move what you can do is to do, you can capture my rook. You can get in the rook after doing my setup. You can get the other rook as well. Then here another means to save the game. I'll do that picture checks. Okay, after I capture the result, what if you capture the I will that you copy plan. Okay, I'll get the picture and maybe I'll see that you want to. Okay, I'm back now too. So now he has two choices to run to capture the bishop. If he captures the bishop, it's okay. I still have a game to play. If he captures the bishop, I capture the rook. You fuck yourself, bro. You finally fought yourself. I'm very yes. I won. This is a very good game, very good game. Oh, zero blunders, zero mistakes. That's a very good game. Yes, I think I played this game very good. 1426 still not my best. 1428 is my best. So I hope I'll reach that tomorrow. Okay, then bye.